Testing. Just want to give everyone a 2-minute warning. If you haven't taken your seats yet, if you can do that as quickly as possible. We're about to start the proceedings in about 2 minutes. Good evening, and welcome to Archbishop Carney's 2023 commencement ceremony. My name is John Borzillo, and as a Carney staff member, I have the privilege of being your master of ceremonies this evening. At this time, I ask you to please be seated, and please silence all cell phones to respect the solemnity of the occasion. Thank you. Our graduating students will now process into their places on the stage. They will be accompanied by Piper George Panagiotou. I ask that you remain seated to give more sight lines for all of the members of the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present Archbishop Carney's graduating students of 2023, followed by the faculty of Archbishop Carney Regional Secondary School. Thank you. to come up towards the stage here, but please do not come on the stage. And if you would like to take some photos, you're more than welcome to. But just keep in mind, please be respectful of other members in the audience. Please remain at your seats as the aisles must remain clear. Once finished, we will then begin our ceremony. So if you would like to come up a little closer and take some photos, you're more than welcome to do so now. Good evening. As we begin this ceremony, we would like to acknowledge that we are gathered here today to celebrate the Archbishop Carney Regional Secondary School graduating class of 2023 on the traditional, ancestral, and unsurrendered territory of the Kwikwetnam First Nation, which lies within the shared territory of the Katsi and Tsleil-Waututh Nation. We would also like to acknowledge all First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples that share their land with all members of this community, where we live, learn, and play. We are grateful for the strong connections our graduates and staff have created, the memories that will last a lifetime, and a future that allows for truth, healing, and reconciliation amongst all peoples. At this time, I would like to invite Kwikwetnam Elder and Knowledge Keeper Stephen Armstrong to begin tonight's ceremony with a welcome.
And then what came to me was looking at all of your pictures. opening of some of our ceremonies. We call it the Coming of Age Ceremony. Looking at your pictures and looking at you right now, I don't see the children that started school 12 years ago. I see young adults. You've chosen so many electives to get to where you are now. The next choice, which is part of your transition, is to choose the path that's now in front of you. As an honored person, a guest to be in your home tonight, I have nothing but respect for all of you. Rosie. I'm a little bit shy because I saw a lot of cameras here tonight. I lied, Curtis was up. Give me a quick second here. As some of you noticed, I was holding the drum close to my chest. The drum is a heartbeat of many nations across this great land that we all share together. One of the things I do, which you heard your MC talk about earlier, is speaking about reconciliation. And I come across this in a positive way. You're going to hear many, many stories in the news about the sadness that has happened. I'm here and I want to ask you, let's not forget what's happened, but let's work and look to the future. Our future right here. And let's work together. We share all these resources together. Right? So it's my hope to see more and more wonderful young minds stepping up to be able to work together. If that's what we're all here for. I just wanted to hear how bad it sounds.
Oh.
with for our nation. And it's called our Coast Salish National Anthem. And it's used in many of our prayer songs when we open up ceremonies. So thank you all again for welcoming me into your home and being a witness to seeing wonderful minds taking the next step in their journey. Oh, see. Oh,
thank you, Quick Whitlam, Elder and Knowledge Keeper Stephen Armstrong. We look forward to continuing our connection with the Quick Whitlam First Nation. At this time, I call forward Ms. Treveri and members of the school choral program to lead us in the singing of O Canada. Please rise. After the singing of the anthem, I ask you to remain standing for the opening prayer. Our Archbishop's representative, Father James Hughes, pastor of Our Lady of Assumption Parish, and Archbishop's rep to our school, will now come forward to lead us in prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Loving Father, on this commandment day, commencement day, let there be a beginning of new life for our graduates. Each of them is a unique creation blessed by you with life and called in love to grow and to share their gifts and light with others. We come together this evening to celebrate their accomplishments, to reflect on who they are, to praise and to thank you for all the love, support, and talents you have given them, and to share our hopes for their future. May this day be filled with happiness and joy. May you continue to bless them and guide them. May they always be surrounded by people who love and support them. May they grow more fully into the men and women that you want them to be, so that they may continue to shine as Carney stars centered in Christ. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you, Father. You may all be seated at this time. Each year, at the graduation ceremony, two students are selected to deliver speeches on behalf of the graduating class. The students selected for these addresses have earned this honor by achieving principal's list standings for their 5 years at Carney, as well as high academic standards in all their grade 12 courses, and have been selected by the graduating students, teachers, and staff. I would like to both congratulate and invite to come forward Alexandra Eve to give the welcoming speech known as the salutatory address. Alexandra.
Good evening, and welcome to all the parents, relatives, faculty members, pastors, honored guests, and Regional Education Committee members who are here with us tonight. I'm incredibly honored to stand here as salutatorian and represent Archbishop Carney's grad class of 2023. On behalf of our whole grade, thank you for joining us in celebrating the hard work and dedication that has brought us here walking across the stage. When I was told my speech should be directed towards welcoming everyone here, I figured if I stood outside the door, learn everyone here's names, and welcome you all by name as a speech, that would cover it. But apparently, that's unrealistic, and the salutatory address is more than just salutations. Put some meaning into it, they said. Okay, I got you. Thank you.
Thank you, Alessandra. It is my pleasure to now invite our school principal, Mr. Linda Julius, to come forward and share some words of congratulations to our graduates. Mr. Julius.
Good evening, everyone. To the graduates of 2023. 5 years ago, I stood in front of you in the gym and spoke to you about the journey we were all undertaking. You were starting grade 8, and I was returning to Carney after 8 years away. I'm not sure who was more nervous that day. During your time at Archbishop Carney, I have had the pleasure of watching you grow into wonderful young men and women. You have had success in athletics with members of your class being a part of numerous teams that qualified for the provincials. You've had success on stage with our musicals, plays, and concerts. You have traveled to the downtown East Side and as far away as New York for service trips. You have attended countless masses, retreats, penitential services, and prayer services. It has definitely been a full 5 years. All those events have helped form you into the person you are and have brought you to this night. The culmination of 5 years of hard work and hopefully a little bit of fun along the way. As I'm sure you have been told by someone already, that while this is the end of one short chapter of your life, it is really the beginning of the rest of your life. You have so much more to look forward to. It was our job to help get you through high school while at the same time preparing you for what is to come. Many of you will leave at the end of this month and go on to some kind of post-secondary institution, while some of you will take some time off of school to work or travel. Each of your paths will be different. What you all have in common, however, is that you know how much Christ loves you. I hope that in your time here, we have been able to show you that Christ will be with you always. He will walk next to you and even carry you when needed. All you need to do is ask Him to be with you. Christ is ready and waiting for you to invite Him to be a part of your life. You have so much to be thankful for. Thank God for being with you and helping you through your most difficult times. Thank your teachers for the time and effort they gave you in tutorials, practices, games, rehearsals, performances, and all the other activities you took part in during your time at our school. Thank your friends for their love, support, and laughter. Finally, thank your parents for choosing to make the necessary sacrifices that come with sending you to our school. Thank them for being with you through any of the difficult times you may have had and for supporting you when you needed it most. Your parents love you more than anyone on this earth. Please make sure that if you thank them for nothing else, that you thank them for that. There's no doubt in my mind that our school is a better place because you are a part of it. We will continue to grow without you, but you have definitely left your mark. You are true Carney stars forever. Taking you back once again to 5 years ago, I'll leave you now with the words I gave you then. In absolutely everything you do, from this day forward, be your best. Congratulations. Thank you.
We will now begin the presentation of diplomas. Thanks to the legacy of Mr. Jacobs, whose dream was that each graduate of the Catholic high schools of the Vancouver Archdiocese would graduate with a rosary, each graduate will also be presented with a rosary handmade by one of our grade 11 students. We hope that our graduates go out into the world equipped with the tools of education and faith. During the presentation, individual pictures will be taken by a contracted photographer and will be available for parents online. Each graduate will have their photo taken, so we ask you to respect this procedure. At this time, I wish to call upon Father James Hughes, our Archbishop's representative, to present the diplomas on behalf of Archbishop Michael Miller, our principal, Mr. Len DeJulius, congratulate each graduate. Our Vice Principal, Mr. Nolay, to distribute the rosaries. And our Vice Principal, Mrs. Jody Sussex, to call each member of the graduating class to come forward.
Courses. so please hold your applause until after I announce that. Aaron Zhao. Aaron is receiving the Lead Learner Award in Calculus 12, Chemistry 12, Physics 12, Pre-Calculus 12, and he has also achieved the distinction of making principals list for all 5 years.
List for all 5 years. Thank you.
and he has also achieved the distinction of making principals list for all 5 years. Daniela Olano.
Thank you.
Brianna Nichols.
Tobichi Iru.
Curry. Isabella Chifriotis.
Sarah Powell.
12. Alex Liu. Alex is receiving the Lead Learner Award in Visual Arts, Media Arts 12, and has also achieved the distinction of making principals list for all 5 years. Zoe Du.
Round of applause for all of you.
Thank you, Father Hughes, Mr. DeJulius, Mrs. Sussex, and Mr. Nolay. I now wish to invite back our Vice Principal, Mrs. Jody Sussex, to recognize students who have received both external scholarships and some special internal awards.
Okay, so this next part of the evening, we're going to start when I call your name for a special award. I'm going to ask you to stand. With the following students, please stand and be recognized for scholarships and or awards they have been offered. Students have the opportunity to apply for many of these awards, scholarships, and bursaries. Some have been internal awards to Archbishop Carney. Some have been external awards. And some scholarships have been self-reported by the graduate. William Clemens, please stand. We'll try that again next time. I'm going to say the name, and then I'll say what they've been given, and then you can clap. Okay, so William Clemens, please stand. William has been awarded the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Creative Writing. Angela Rachel Deleuze, please stand. Rachel has been awarded the Electra Women's Choir Youth Scholarship, the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Popular Music. Congratulations. Alessandra Eve has been awarded the Art Focus Artists Association Scholarship. Has been awarded the Future Achievement in Dance Scholarship and the Dominic Mobilio Memorial Scholarship. Ashley E. Wang has been awarded the University of British Columbia Outstanding International Student Award. Has been awarded the Trinity Western Soccer Scholarship and Academic Scholarship. Faith Kiros has won the Unsung Hero Award for her behind-the-scenes support and service to the school and community. Has won the Archbishop Carney Star Lament Outstanding Student Leadership Award. Kitty Lau has won the Longevity Graphics Zoe Boudreaux Bursary. Danica Lorenz has won the Archbishop Carney Performing Arts Scholarship. Dominic Matalozzo has won the BC Catholics Tessa Beauchamp Scholarship, the St. Luke CWL Bursary, the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship in Community Leadership, the Dominic Mobilio Memorial Scholarship, the 8th Knights of Columbus Bursary, and the Archbishop Carney Athletics and Physical Health Education Scholarship. Aiden Madden has won the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Performance in Individual Sports. Has won the Bank of Montreal National Award, Queen's University Major Admission Award, the BISC Tricolor Award, John Brooks Foundation Scholarship, Queen's University Work Study Award, the 8th Knights of Columbus Bursary, and the Archbishop Carney Star Lament Outstanding Student Leadership Award. Has won the Canwell Peters Scholarship. Miles Pomeroy, the Trinity Western University Dean's Scholarship. Diego Santos, the Unsung Hero Award for his behind-the-scenes support and service to the school and community. Stephanie Schneider, the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Leadership in Sport. Nicole Satowski, the QB 622 Member Scholarship. Sarah Song, the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Classical Music. Sophia Stallone, the QP 622 Member Scholarship. Aaron Zhao. Don't hold your breath, hold on. Dean of Science, Regional Science Fair winner, undergraduate scholarship, BCIC Young Innovator Scholarship, Ingenious Plus Innovation Challenge, regionals and national finalists. Aaron was one of only 5 students across Canada to have received this award. McMaster Engineering Award for Excellence, University of Ottawa Admission Scholarship, Canada-wide Science Fair Bronze Entrance Scholarship to Western, and Aaron has also received the Dogwood District Authority Scholarship for Innovation. James Carney Memorial Scholarship to two students for excellence in academics, active involvement in the school community, and being a Christian witness through their actions. This year, the award is presented to Stephanie Schneider and Dominic Mataloza. Mr. Peter Daw, Mrs. Lorraine Peruzzolo, and Deacon Hank Luton. It is awarded to the student chosen by the current principal to have made outstanding contributions to the Carney community, who have demonstrated excellence in our school's four pillars of academics, athletics, fine arts, and faith to our community. This year, the award is presented to Dominic Mataloza.
Thank you, Mrs. Sussex. On behalf of the Archbishop Carney School community, I would like to congratulate and invite Aaron Zhao to come forward to present the valedictory address on behalf of the class of 2023.
So, I was in the shower this morning when I realized that the grade 8s next year are all born in 2010. And when they graduate, I'm going to be 23 years old. Guys, we are ancient. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, family, faculty, and the graduating class of 2023. The day we've longed for, but also feared, for the past 5 years is time to go. The day when we sit in the study with a lump in our throat as the clock ticks on and the end of high school approaches us. What's interesting is that 5 years ago, we had the exact same lump in our throat, but that time, we were sitting in the school gym as the same clock ticked on, but the beginning of high school approaches us. When we entered Carney for the first time in grade 8, we were clueless. We couldn't find our classrooms, didn't know how to use combination locks, most of us still don't. And constantly complained that we had a bottom lock. We asked each other what the 2023 at the end of our school emails meant, because we really had no sense of time. And by mid-grade 8, everyone had a grade 12 crush. I promise you, your kid in grade 8 definitely took a grade 12 headshot from your book, found the person, and spent a good amount of time. And we definitely still do remember something. So, No, she's 23, it's not good. Anyways, back to grade 8. What also made grade 8 such a crazy year were the little stories we come home with every week. I remember one day in class, we were making chocolate chip cookies. Now, my group wasn't really taking the project seriously because, well, none of us like baking or cookies. So we're just, you know, getting that as fast as we can. And then we added what we thought was a half cup of sugar. So carelessly we dumped it all in, mixed it all up, threw it in the oven, and waited. When the cookies came out, they looked wonderful. Until it went this way. The half dog was not sugar. It was salt. We didn't do very well that night. See, it's moments like these that define our grade 8 year. Sometimes life is sweet, and other times it was salty. Like, morbidly salty. But really, we didn't care. We were all just carelessly experimenting with this new life of ours, and just living life as how it came to us. When grade 9 rolled along, honestly, not much changed in grade 8. We still put on Mr. Borzillo. Wondering where the air conditioning was. And sorry, there's one more thing. Oh yeah, wondering where the air conditioning was. But then something weird happened near the end of the night. At home, people started losing their sense of taste and smell. A lot of people were getting fevers a little too quickly. At school, whenever someone sneezed, everyone took a little step back. And one day, Mr. DeJulius came to school with bloodshot eyes, wearing a tutu and ballet shoes. Okay, I made that up. Please don't be doing it all. Anyways, COVID-19 happened. That was one weird error. We weren't exaggerating when we say we woke up a minute before school, because we really did wake up a minute before school. Even though our bedroom became our classroom, like physically, some people still found a way to be late for class in the morning. Someone enlighten me, please. How do you wake up in school and still be late for school? It doesn't make sense. Anyways. And another interesting thing is, we forget what each other's spaces look like after mass research has ended. I remember in the first morning we were back without mass, I'm walking down the hallway and my friend comes up to me and says, "Oh, you look like that?" And so casually I told him, "You look better with a mask on." Anyways, by the time most COVID restrictions came to an end, we were in grade 12. We were seniors. Sitting here, it set us where our school emails all end in 2023. Because this is it, our last year together. Or rather, our last month together. Or rather, our last week together. Most of us will never hear Mr. Arruda's guttural screams down the hallway ever again. We won't walk into science lab to university and see Mr. Yaskovich's massive Hot Wheels collection of Lego sets. Or hear Mr. Patkai's singular joke like every other class, that's about the funniest thing you've heard all week. When we walk into our math class, we're not going to see any of Mr. Flores' math humor on the screen. My favorite one from Stegos, "I want to skip math class." Until I realized I was a teacher. We won't hear Mr. Harrison's Chewbacca sounds as he joyously tramples over grade 8's in the hallway. Sometimes he looks like he's had a little bit too much fun doing that. And most sadly, some of us here might tear up a little as I say this, we won't ever hear Jerry's super obnoxious, "Jerry, you want to say it?" Jerry, play that one more time next week. I'm walking right out. Looking back, there's a lot of things we're going to miss, and these heartwarming memories wouldn't have been made without certain people. So firstly, on behalf of my class, I want to thank all the teachers at Carney for training us to think independently. Whether or not we paid attention in class or submitted assignments on time, you were so incredibly patient with us, and we will forever be grateful for the knowledge that you can. Next, I want to thank our parents for your endless support, care, and love for us. Even though sometimes we drive you to the verge of insanity, like make you drive all the way home, and then all the way back to school because we forgot something, you still love us, and we know that sometimes it's not easy. I also want to thank our friends, past and present, for teaching us lessons, for having each other's backs, and making us smile on days when smiling seems impossible. Finally, I want to thank God for staying with us through exhausting mornings, bored afternoons, and lonely nights. Every moment he is with us, working on our lives. So thank you. And now, after 5 years, it's time to say goodbye to everything you knew about us. Everything. You know that feeling when you finish a really good movie, and you sit there and you kind of watch the credits roll by, and you ask yourself, so what's next? We kind of feel better. Except, we're no longer as clueless as we were back in grade 8. And no, we're not just class graduating teenagers with funny, itchy hats on our heads. We're a family of stars. There are sons, daughters, sisters, brothers sitting here with opportunities to dance in southern France, play professional soccer in Italy, learn business in Atlanta, and pursue fashion design in California. There are future doctors, therapists, nurses, engineers, teachers sitting in this crowd, getting ready to build and improve the future. There are also people in this setting, parents and their children, who don't know those things, who don't know what to say, who don't know what to expect in the future. But that is exactly what makes life so exciting, the fact that we don't know. So however you're feeling about the future, keep marching forward. When the pain and suffering of life breaks upon you, you will straighten your back and look up into the sky with determination and strength. In fact, Luke chapter 14, verse 27 shows very clearly that you are called by God to shoulder your cross, to pick up your burdens, and let Jesus Christ triumph over sin. And when the sneers and snarks, teases and barks of the world ring in your ears, you will do nothing but stand there smiling, because you are fully aware that the world has nothing on you. Sometimes it will try and make you feel vulnerable, insufficient, weak, jealous, but that can never, ever stop you from becoming who you're meant to be. And so with that, Carney's graduating class, 2023. We sit here as the same clock ticks on at the end of high school ages. I know I've been up here preaching like I'm married and have 3 grandchildren already. But deep down, I'm as concerned as you are. However, there are 2 things I know for certain. We're not an easy punch. We'll be more than one. Thank you.
Still telling them what to do. This is my last class. This was the last group I taught. After that, I've got a different role at school, so they're special kids. Thank you, Eric. To conclude our ceremonies, I invite Father Hughes to come forward to lead us in the final prayer and blessing of our 2023 graduates. So we invite our graduates to please stand at this time.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May God send his richest blessings of true happiness to you. May you find that he is by your side to light your way in everything you do. May his deep and tender love be with you day by day to help you and to guide you every step along life's way. May you always be aware that knowledge comes from learning, and wisdom comes from God, the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, we praise you for your glory and thank you for your goodness to us. May your Spirit guide these graduates to use their many talents and skills, and for your glory and for the good of all people. Look on these graduates, our Carney stars of 2023, and with your love, your light, and your prayer, and bless them as they leave this school to move forward in life. Loving Father, we ask this grace through Christ our Lord, in whom our school is truly centered. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you, Father. Aaron, can you come back down here? We did forget something. So I'm going to let you take the lead. I think you know what it is. I'm going to let you take the lead.
All right, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me a great honor to present to you Archbishop Carney's graduating class of 2023.